Hey, what is up, guys? My name is Oleg. Welcome to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to do a full review of TV's or TVI's reference number T801A. It's a fully automatic Rolex Submariner homage from China. I purchased mine from gearbest.com, spent about $17 online, including shipping to Canada. To be fair, I did buy it during a flash sale. I think the regular price for this watch is around $22 to $23. So by no means an expensive watch. In fact, it might be the cheapest Rolex Submariner homage. So is it any good? Well, watch the review and judge for yourself. I'm gonna go over all the positives, all the negatives, give you some close-up shots, and hopefully by the end of this video you'll have your opinion made up whether you should buy this one or maybe save up for something a little bit better. Now before we get started with the review, I'd like to say a few words, and I'd like to thank all of you guys for the support that I received. I started this channel just a couple of months ago. I really didn't know what to expect. I mean, I'm by no means an expert in the watch industry. I'm just an enthusiast, and a lot of you out there know a lot more about watches than I do, I'm sure of that. But nevertheless, I did receive a lot of positive feedback, a lot of support from you guys. So I'd just like to thank all of you, everyone who liked the videos, who subscribed, even the ones that disliked. It's all great feedback to me. And once again, thank you so much. I will continue producing more content for you in the future, and hopefully you like it. All right, let's get started with the review.
All right, guys, so here's the watch that we're gonna talk about. We'll look at some basic dimensions, the case, the finishes. I'll go over some of the positives, some of the negatives about this watch. I give you a loom shot, a wrist shot, and at the end of this video, I'll share my personal thoughts on whether you should purchase this watch or perhaps stay away. So let's get started with the basic dimensions. So it's 42 millimeters in diameter, 50 millimeters lug to lug, just a little over 14 millimeters thick. We have a 20 millimeter lug width that tampers down to about, I believe, 16 millimeters. That's right, about 16 millimeters. So let's take a look at the case. We have a stainless steel case with a stainless steel bracelet. It's an oyster style bracelet with two-tone finish. We have brushed side links with polished metal links. The polishing is actually done pretty well. We have a pressed metal clasp here, and the clasp is actually signed, the Visa logo at the top here, with a push button release mechanism. There is a displaced case back here with a signed router, and we have a unidirectional rotating bezel. The dial is black with a bit of a sunburst effect. We have applied indices all around for hour markings, and there's also applied loom. I will pop a loom shot on a screen right now. We also have a date window at the 3 o'clock position with a bit of a cyclops, or the magnifier here. The magnifier doesn't magnify that much, but it does a bit. We do have crown guards on the side, and of course the crown is the 3 hour position. So let's talk about the positives on this watch, and the list is actually surprisingly long for a watch that costs $17. And actually the price and the value for the price is the biggest positive for this watch. I mean, for $17, it's amazing that the watch is this good. I mean, for $17 automatic watch, stainless steel, I was kind of expecting it to disintegrate as soon as I picked it out of the box, but it's here and it works, and it is truly fully automatic watch. So actually the second positive is the movement. As I've said before, it is an automatic movement, and actually also has a hand wind to it as well, which is very impressive for only $17. I mean, a lot of Seikos don't have hand winding with their movements, and I mean, if you ask me, they should, but that's a different story. Another positive, of course, is that signed router at the back here, again, a nice detail from Tavis. They didn't have to do it, but they did. There's a bit of decoration on as well. And the display case back, another nice touch from the company that already provided a lot of value for the money. So those are all just bonuses in my book. The movement is actually fairly accurate. I'm getting about 36 seconds fast per day. Not too bad for any other watch. I would be complaining about that. For this particular one, not bad at all. I mean, I've experienced watches that are $300 to $400 that are running around 30-40 seconds fast. And there are some videos on YouTube about regulating this movement. I'm not sure if I would be regulating it because of the price and just because I don't really care about such a small discrepancy in timekeeping. The weight of the watch also is pretty good. It does feel fairly hefty on the wrist when you wear it. It doesn't feel as solid as a Seiko SKX or even the Seiko Flightmaster that I was reviewing last week. Of course, those watches cost 10 times as much as this watch, but it does feel fairly nice on the wrist. It has a pretty good presence and a pretty good weight. Another positive is this bracelet. So as I mentioned before, it's an Oyster style bracelet, and we do have all solid links here, which is pretty impressive for watching this price range. The clasp is pretty nice. As I mentioned before, it is signed, and this release mechanism is pretty good. It does feel secure. It doesn't feel like it's gonna pop off the wrist. There is a bit of a play here, but when I wear it on wrist, I'm never scared that it's gonna fly off. Now let's take a little bit of a closer look at this dial, because the dial itself is pretty nice. We have a fully black dial with a bit of a sunburst effect. And again, for the watch in this price range, it's pretty impressive. Applied indices for hour markings, they are loomed, and we also have loomed hands. And I already did a loom shot, so you already know that. A few other details. We have guard on this crown, and the crown is signed. Again, a nice touch from Tavis. And actually, anywhere on this watch, it doesn't say that it's made in China or it features a Chinese movement. I'm not sure if it's a positive or a negative. Take it as you will. I count it as a positive. But it's just something to be aware of. So obviously the watch has date functionality. We can see a date window at 3 o'clock marking here. Let me pull out the crown and show you. It does have a quick set date. All right. So the date change is a bit wobbly, but it works perfectly fine. Again, comparing this to Vostok Komandirsky, over there you have to go past 9 and past 12 a bunch of times to change the date. Quick set date, a plus in my book. Quite a few positives for this watch, especially considering the price. However, it's not a perfect watch, and to get the price down so low, obviously some shortcuts had to be taken. Here are some of the negatives that I found with this watch. Some are bigger than others. Some you would think are just petty, but again, this is a review, so I have to mention everything that I noticed. And number one, and by far the biggest complaint that I have about this watch, is the power reserve. I only find it to be around 15 hours on this watch, which is very little. If you take extra long sleep, or if you just take the watch off the wrist and forget to put it on for a couple of hours in the morning, it will stop ticking. Even with the hand winding, I still found it to be around 15 hours. So that by far to me is the biggest negative with the watch. Another negative and kind of external sign of this watch being a little on the cheap side is this bezel. So the bezel action is awful. I mean, look at the play on this bezel. It can go back almost 3 minutes. Again, to be expected on a watch of this price, but it's something that gives away kind of the price for this watch right away as soon as you try to turn it. My watch also has the bezel come off the case a little bit, and this point here at the bottom, it's nowhere else except for here, so you can see even makes a sound when I tap on it. So a bit of a negative there. The bezel also doesn't align properly. It does align if you kind of push it off its axis a little bit, because there's so much play on the bezel, I guess that allows it to be aligned properly with just a little bit of adjustment here. Another pretty big negative with this watch is the lack of a screw down crown, but more importantly, the overall poor depth rating. I mean, if you're buying a Rolex Submariner Homage, one of the most popular, if not the most popular diver watches in the world, you want a watch that you can at least go diving with, or maybe not diving, but at least go swimming with. This watch, of course, has a 100 feet or 30 meters, 3 atmospheres depth reading, which is very little. I mean, you can't go swimming with this watch for sure. Maybe washing your dishes is okay. And even washing dishes, I found a little bit of water getting into it. So definitely not a diver watch, although it does look like one. To me, that's a bit of a deal killer, because again, you're buying a watch that looks like a diver watch and you want to have at least some of that diver functionality. I mean, even Invictus have a 200 meter depth rating. This one can't really do much about that. Again, some people might think it's not a big negative. To me, it is, but considering the price, I have to keep my expectations reasonable. A few other smaller negatives. Number one is the hollow end links here. Again, not a huge deal. A lot of other watches, much more expensive than this one, have hollow end links. I'm looking at you, Seiko. Number two, and more importantly, with this bracelet, it did pick up some scratches and some scuffs already. I've been wearing this watch for 1 week straight on my wrist and a second week on and off the wrist. Light wearing, went to the gym a couple of times, did some light cardio, walking the dog, wearing around the house, to the office, things like that. Nothing major, already picked up some scratches on the bracelet. The case does look pretty good. So, you know, maybe pop this one on a NATO and don't worry about the bracelet. Although again, as I said, with my positives, I do like the bracelet. I like it being tapering down to about 16 millimeters here. And I also like the solid links, but it did pick up some scuffs and scratches. So the quality of the stainless steel that was used is not the best. Another thing here on the dial says perlative and should say chronometer, but it says a different word. I don't know how to pronounce that, but it's definitely not a chronometer and definitely not a superlative like the original should be. And here's what the watch looks like on my 7.25 inch wrist. Timeless design, no wonder a lot of people are copying it. It just looks wonderful. Even in a larger size. I actually prefer a little bit of a larger size for this watch, and I like my divers to be a little bit larger. So here it is on the wrist, and actually asking people that don't know too much about the watches what they thought this watch is worth. A lot of people said around $150 to $180. So that's gotta give you an idea what it looks like on the wrist to somebody who doesn't know too much about watches.
So that was my review of Tivis or Tivis reference number T801A. Thanks for watching this video. I have a lot more content coming our way. I actually purchased another Tivis. This one is open heart, day and night, or a moon and sun phase indicator. And this one was also very cheap. I'm not gonna disclose how much just yet, but pretty soon I'll do an unboxing of that watch. I also purchased another Rolex Submariner Homage. I'm not gonna tell you what company it's from, but let's just say it's from a small South Korean company. I think a lot of you out there know what it is. Maybe leave your comments in the comment section below. It's arriving in the mail as we speak. So as soon as I get it, I'll do an unboxing and the review for that watch as well. Once again, thank you for watching this one. Like and subscribe. I release new videos every Friday, and I'll see you next time.